Hi everyone, welcome back to Chandan Logics. So today we are going to discuss July 5th current affairs, and we are going to deal with the concepts international affairs, state news, government schemes, as well as books and authors. Okay, so let us start our class with the first topic related for the international affairs. So the first topic is about Indus Water Treaty. Okay, so this is about Indus Treaty, that too about what India to use the excess water to irrigate own land. That means, as per the Jal Shakti Minister, who is that covered the static part here, Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, India is working to its rights. What is that? To stop the excess usage of water by Pakistan, that too for the irrigate its own lands. As well as, if you see, actually, what is the background of this Indus Water Treaty is, Indus Water Treaty actually signed in the year 1960. That is between, the agreement is between whom? India as well as Pakistan. So here we will see about the Indus River System. What is that Indus River System? Here Indus River System actually covers the western rivers as well as the eastern rivers. You can see that the river Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. So this is the Indus River System. Okay, so about this Indus River System, the Indus Waters Treaty was signed in 1960, and if you see that here, western as well as eastern rivers were covered. That means like three rivers will be used, like that means from these rivers the water can be used by the to these two countries, India and Pakistan. And if you see, this treaty was signed along with the third party. The third party is the World Bank. Okay, that is a third party here. And if you see this Indus Water Treaty, and if you see in the map like where the rivers are flowing, that means from this Indus, if you see Jhelum, Chenab and Satluj, and here you can see the part Indus, right? So here you can see that the part that means these are the rivers covering both India as well as the Pakistan also. So this is the treaty between the India and Pakistan about the Indus Waters Treaty 1960. This is a very important topic, and also once you go through in a detailed manner, still if you have doubt. Next, if we move into the state news, the first one is about the ban of storage, use and possession as well as transportation of the UAVs. Unnamed aerial vehicles, okay, that is in Srinagar. So actually, why this decision has to, what is the reason means, if you see on June 27th, the drone attack has done on the Jammu Air Force Station. So based on this attack, that means this drone attack, so here Srinagar is going to ban the UAVs. That means even usage, storage and transportation of these UAVs were completely banned in Srinagar now. And if you see here, actually this drone attack is being seen as a display of capability and attempt to put the pressure on the fragile ceasefire. So here we are saying about ceasefire. What is it? Military order for cease firing. That we call it as ceasefire. And coming to the part, what is that? Line of control. So actually, unofficially, if you see that, the length of this line of control is 776 kilometers. And coming to the part line of control, we are saying actually this is a boundary, we can say that live line of control, that means a border of separating India and Pakistan. And here you can see that Pakistan is occupying the, what are the two countries involved here? India and Pakistan. So here some part of Jammu and Kashmir, okay, actually Jammu and Kashmir is controlled by which country? India. but here illegally Pakistan is occupying the part of this Jammu and Kashmir, like Azad Kashmir and Balochistan are the places which is Pakistan is occupying. So this is the case, we call it as what? Line of control. So here you can see that it is also aimed at the disrupting political process in Kashmir also. So because of this, what we can say, illegal occupying of the regions, that means some parts of Jammu and Kashmir, so this line of control is taking place, as well as cease firing is done. So mainly of these, that means using of drones is completely banned in Srinagar. Also you can see that, coming to the news, what is that order ask about the authorities to secure the aerial space near the vital installations and highly populated areas, and it is also mandated that drones should not be used even in the cultural events. Why? Because like nowadays in cultural events and in some, like what we can say, meetings, drones are using, but even for that also, that completely here usage of drones and UAVs were banned in Srinagar. So that is in news, and these are the two important topics. International affairs we have dealt with, Indus Water Treaty, as well as this drone, like what we can say, ban is important for your exam. So concentrate on these topics. Next, coming to the economy sector, that is about Flipkart. So here Flipkart and PhonePe to launch the contactless scan and pay feature. What is that contactless scan and pay feature we are seeing? But because nowadays in this crisis, mainly major of the, like, people are what, focusing towards the contactless payments only, right? So here based on that also, like, that is also one reason to take this, like bringing this feature here. What are the two concepts you can cover here? PhonePe, right? And this is a digital payment app, as well as the e-commerce app is Flipkart, right? So these two, like, joining and bringing the new feature, that is in the Flipkart, what is that? Scan and pay through the QR code. Yes, so here through UPIs the customer can pay when their order has delivered. That means previously, like, major of we are preferring for what? Cash on delivery, right? That means after the product has delivered, then we will pay the cash. So in the same way, now when the product has delivered for the customer, then at the point of time they can, like, scan the QR code and they can pay the money. So this is a option, that means is a new feature that Flipkart is going to bring through the PhonePe. Is it clear now? So mainly this is for what? Pay on delivery orders. Okay, that means before it was like cash on delivery we used to say, no? So that is going to replace with this scan and pay feature. Next, coming to the appointments. So what is the first one? Satish Agnihotri take charge as a Managing Director of NHSRCL. So actually what is meant by NHSRCL? National High Speed Rail Corporation Limited. It was like, if you see the background of this NHCRL, so was established in the 2016, according to the act we call it as 2013. Okay, so this was established in 2016, and what is the main objective, that the objective of NHCRL, that is mainly to manage, to finance and to monitor this high speed, like, rail network and this corporation in the country. So that is the main object. That means even financial is also, like, produced, okay, provided. That is the main objective of this NHSRCL. Okay, and now here comes to the appointment. Who is that person? Satish Agnihotri. So, like, who are the persons chosen for this managing director of this, like, these type of corporations limited? That means here you can see, like, the person should have the experience regarding that sector, that means related to the same rail sector. That means here he has having the experience of more than 20 years in the mega rail infrastructure projects. So considering this experience also, the persons has been selected for these various types of major corporations. Okay, so here, and also he has worked as a chairman as well as managing director of Rail Vikas Nigam Limited, RVNL, and scheduled a CPSC under the Ministry of Railways for close to 9 years. So considering all these areas previously in which areas he has worked, then the person has selected for this Managing Director of NHSRCL Limited. So now here you have to focus on the ministry, and you can see the photography of the person who has appointed, Satish Agnihotri. And here what is the ministry? Here we have covered Ministry of Railways. Is it clear enough? Next, coming to the banking sector. So what is the first one? RBI imposes rupees 25 lakh penalty on the Punjab Sind Bank. So why? What is the reason? Actually, because for the non-compliance with the certain provisions and directions of cyber security framework in banks. So here cyber security attacks will be done on the banks majorly. For what? For the false transactions will be done. So the data will be collected by these people and they will use for these false transactions. So here, based on these false transactions, who will affect? Both customers as well as banks will be get affected by these cyber security attacks in the banking sector. Is it clear? So customers and banks both will get affected by the cyber acts. So here we are saying like non-compliance. So what is meant by non-compliance here? So like to follow like on these cyber security reports. So based on this, RBI will give some cyber security guidelines for the banks, so that banks should follow that guidelines. Okay, but here if the bank has not followed that RBI security guidelines, that means cyber security guidelines, then RBI will take the charge. So now Punjab Sind Bank has not followed these cyber security guidelines, so that we call it as non-compliance. So based on this only, RBI has imposed the rupees 25 lakhs as a penalty on Punjab Sind Bank. Is it clear now? What is the reason for imposing this penalty? So now, if you see the static part, that is about what? Punjab Sind Bank is there, no? The established year is 1908 on 24th June, and MD and CEO of Punjab Sind Bank is S. Krishnan. Next, coming to the awards and recognitions. What is that? About Invest India. So here Invest India won the most innovative investment promotion agency of 2021 award. Actually, this is presented by OCO Global. OCO Global is a leading authority of the foreign investment and offers some range of economic development services as well as unique company assessment tools. So this is like, this award was presented by OCO Global. So now coming to the part, actually what is that about Invest India? So this has only won the award, no? So now we will know about Invest India. What is that? This is a non-profit venture which was set up in the year 2009 under the Department for Promotion of Internal Trade and Industry, as well as Ministry of Commerce and Industry and Government of India. So here we can see that Invest India logo, that means this is a National Investment Promotion and Facilitation Agency. This is a investment and facilitation agency, Invest India is. So here this comes under the Department of Promotion and Internal Trade, we have said DPIIT. Actually this name was renamed in 2019. If you see the history, first it was like DIPP. So Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion in the year 1995. Okay, so this is the history, but it has renamed its name in 2019 as a DPIIT. Then what is the role of this DPIIT? This will mainly look after the internal trade and industrial policies, as well as it will like formulate and regulate the foreign direct investments, intellectual property rights, and it will look after the employees like who are about what protecting the employees regarding the investment sector. And here we are dealing with what Invest India, and the awards is about what innovative investments. So here how the investment like plays the role in developing the economy. So here you have to remember one thing, note this part, what is that DPIIT as well as DIPP. Then we will discuss about the how investment will plays the role in like what we can say in developing the economy. So have you noted this? Now we will see that formula, what is that? So if the investment is high, then coming to that what? Emolument, then coming to the high expenditure. Then if expenditure is high, what will be the next? High production. That means the production has a focus on what? Increasing the high GDP. So note this here, investment is directly like focusing on what? Increasing the economy. So here investment, when investment increases, so there will be the development in the economy. So this is a part you can cover here. So note this flowchart, if investments other than emoluments, then comes to the high expenditure, then comes to high production, then comes to high GDP. Okay, so this is a flowchart which will be useful for you in the economy sector. That means how investment will affect the economy also. Next, coming to the government schemes. So what is the first one? Nipun Bharat Initiative. So mainly this Nipun Bharat Initiative is, that means, going to cover under the school education program. We know it is as a Samagra Siksha Abhiyan. So here in our previous classes we have discussed about Samagra Siksha Abhiyan in a detailed way. So it has like subsumed from three schemes, as we know that. Okay, so once you go through that, as well as you can cover that here. The main aim of objective of the Samagra Siksha Abhiyan is what? About what? To improve the school education, that means in a quality level, as well as gender equality should not be there. And here sustainable development goals also covered, like SDG 4.1, sustainable development goal number 4.1 and 4.5. As well as here education comes under the concurrent list. So according to the 7th schedule we have three lists. Okay, so in that concurrent list is the third one. So in this concurrent list education takes place. So here these SDGs will also cover here. Okay, that means right to education. Okay, article 21A is also will be covered in this part. So here Nipun Bharat Initiative, we are saying mainly this is to focus about the, that means, improving the children's learning in from the pre, the Samagra Siksha Abhiyan is about what? Focusing on the school education from preschool to the senior secondary level. Okay, that means till 12th. And here this Nipun is mainly focusing on the school education, that means the students should be learned and the activities will be involved in what? In the conceptual basis, that means understanding and numeracy should be improved in the students. That means here actually rote learning is habituated by the students, right? So to eliminate this rote learning, mainly this understanding the concept, that means you should learn based on what? The understanding the concepts and numeracy. So that is focused in this Nipun Bharat Initiative, and Union Government has set up, that means on July 5th. So about this initiative, and you can see here the full form of the Nipun Bharat is National Initiative for Proficiency in Reading with Understanding and Numeracy. So just not only like reading, the concepts should be understood by the students. And here Samagra Siksha Abhiyan mainly focuses on technology and teachers also. Okay, two T's. Next, coming to the COVIN Global Conclave. So this COVIN Global Conclave held on July 5th, 2021, Prime Minister Narendra Modi shared his thoughts in that conclave. So about what? About that COVID platform, that means India is going to offer this COVID platform as a digital public good. So actually what is meant by digital public good, we will see. Before that, the India is going to offer as a digital COVID as a digital public good for the other countries for their running of their vaccination drives. So here mainly 50 countries are showing interest to adopt this COVID app. And coming to that, this is a joint initiative of Union Ministers of Health, External Affairs and NHA, National Health Authority. So here you can see that what is that based on the what we are saying, digital public goods we are saying. That means the main theme is what? Digital public goods means open software we used to say, right? And open digital platforms and open AI models and data will be available for everyone. Open digital software means what? The data will, that means the software will be available for, or that means the, that is the source that anyone can use. Here same way COVID app was also, like means India is going, will be offering this COVID app as a open software source. Okay, that means in any, all over the world, in any country, they can use the COVID app for the vaccination drive. That we call it as what we can say, digital public goods. So here you can know about COVID. What is that? COVID means what? COVID vaccination intelligence network. And here this is the enhanced version and developed version of what we can say, EVIN, electronic vaccine vaccination drive, what we can say, intelligence network. This is the enhanced version and developed version of EVIN. So I think you have don't know about the like background. The first, this was there like electronic vaccine intelligence network, then that is the developed network, that means the network called COVID app. So here what is the use of COVID app? That any person in any area, that means it is available on both iOS as well as Android. Is so here like a person can digitally, that means they can self registered for the vaccination. So they can see the slots and as well as vaccination centers nearby them, and they can give the, that we can, they can book the slot for the vaccination purpose. So that is the use of this COVID app. Coming to the books and authors. So what is the first one? Lady Doctor, The Untold Stories of India's First Woman in Medicine by Kavita Roy. So what is the title of the book? Lady Doctor, The Untold Stories of the India's First Woman in the Medical Field. That means this is the title of the book. Then who is the author? Kavita Rao. So actually then what they have described in this book? This book recovers the stories of India's first woman doctors, often ignored by the history. That is about whom? About the story of Rukmabai Raut. Who is that? Rukmabai Raut. And you can see the cover page of the book, Lady Doctors, The Untold Stories of First Woman in Medicine, that is written by Kavita Rao. So you can see the picture also like Rukmabai Raut here. So here coming to the history of Rukmabai Raut, what is that? Rukmabai Raut was an Indian physician and feminist, and she is best known for what? For being one of the first practicing women doctors in colonial India, as well as one important role she has played in the, as a legal case we are saying, involving what? Her marriage as a child bride between 1884 and 1888. Actually here one case, legal case they are saying, no. So what is that case means? Here age of consent in the time of British India, that is Age of Consent Act 1891. So if you see now, like 18 is a like age of marriage, like now we can see. So in the previous days, in the British India, so here the Age of Consent Act, no, that is 1891. So according to this act, that means amended, and it has changed to from 10 to 12 years of marriage. That means after her marriage only, that means according to this Age of Consent Act 1891, the age has changed from 10 to 12 years. Okay, so focus on this Age of Consent Act also. That means this is a major role played in this legal case. This is about the Rukmabai Raut, and she was Indian physician, that means as well as a first you can say that the first woman in the medicine field. So this is the book author and as well as the what we can say the like description in that book. And here today you have to like mainly focus on the topics called, the first one is about Indus Water Treaty and as well as about the ban of drones in Srinagar. This is the second topic important for you, as well as the important topics is mainly about the Samagra Siksha Abhiyan. Okay, that means focus on the these important topics today. Why? Because this is a major important topics, mainly you will ask the in your like exams for these topics related. Mainly they'll ask you the questions regarding like history or else some economic sector. Okay, and as well as you can cover this Rukmabai Rauth case also, that is about the age of consent. So 4 to 5 topics are very important on this July 5th current affairs. So once you go through in a detailed way of explanation through that, so if you're still having the doubt like any part, once you mention in the comment section, we will discuss in our classes. So let us conclude our class. Everyone use your day, that means every day you treat as a great opportunity, that means to learn something new and unique. So see, today we have learned something new in our classes. Daily we are not repeating the same topics, like something we are learning new. So in the same way, use every day in a worthful manner and reach your goals. Thank you. We will meet you in the next class. Everyone stay safe and stay home.